must humbly beg your pardon, but I'm in quite a predicament, see. I'm a wandering juggler from Occupy Temeria and...
Temeria? You sure? Not Novigrad?
What? Why Novigrad? No, I come from Maribor and...
You're not cut out for this line of work. Memory's too short. See, we've met. But you were a respected Novigrad merchant who wanted desperately to get home.
But I assure you, All right, you got me. I know this all looks bad, but I swear I'll pay you back, mate. All of it, with interest. Just, please, don't take me to the Jarl.
Think you could fool me a second time? I'm gonna let the Jarl decide what to do with you.
Force me to come with you? Go ahead, try.
I've battled in worse weather than this. I battled in worse weather than this.
Slow now, whoa. Yeah.
this chain.
Never fight a dragon.
You put it here, hold it, and chop.
My dad's off liking the black ones. And I want to build a long ship.
Time will come for that. But you gotta start with the fundamentals. So come here. Look.
Mighty warrior, that one.
Still sizzling.
In a way, it's fun, isn't it?
Maybe they got lost.
They've been hauling lumber along this road for 20 years.
Mm-hmm. May your axe never crumble.
Can I come for you, Yoris? You want loin? Maybe some
you
sugar?
Staying on?
Nothing.
Rather, seems to me this meat's got worms.
Worms? Put worms on your brain? Them's the only worms here. Don't like they make goat juice on the grass.
That odd boy.
Friends, we show heart. Foes, we show our axe.
Where? Not exactly frisky round the cows.
You're surprised. Been at it for years. We've been plowing. Oh.
Speak for yourself, Olaf. Not a wee bit, I reckon, but my coin says he can't beat the giant. He's looking to get hired on a ship.
Around here, huh?
Oi,
hurt their server and them
heads. Got an offer for you.
Aye, it's there. It ain't so easy to get it out.
Why is that? Vein too deep in the rock?
Nay, there's something in those caves. Something that kills any man that enters. Pickaxe in hand or no.
What's this offer? Got a contract for me?
Might do, if you're willing to partner with me.
Usually work alone.
Could pay to make an exception this time. It's not every day you get a chance to work with the most renowned bounty hunter north of the Yaruga, Jenga Fred himself.
I'll bite. What's the famous Jenga Fred need a witcher for?
I'm guessing you're a man of the world. Perhaps you've come across the Grossbart brothers in your travels.
You hunting them?
Aye, quite the rogues they are. Three of them, and everyone's got a pack of rapes and murders under his belt. Even took to grave robbing lately. Easy to recognize on account of the yellow caps they wear. Folks see three yellow tops, they flee to their huts. Which don't help much, of course, because they're also fond of arson.
No, haven't met him.
If you do, tread careful. They're quick to stick a knife in a man's gut, often just by way of greeting.
Doubt they'd try that with a witcher.
You never know with that lot. Right, well, I head south soon. Haven't looked there yet. Fare you well. You might meet again someday. Oh.
Sailing this time.
Kerak, they've out went there to sell furs. Said they've not got a full garrison.
Oh, aye. Must have sent men against the black ones.
I could have married a continental man.
Not expecting anyone to strike from the sea.
No.
Then they're in for a surprise. And we're in for glory and riches.
Where's your road wind?
Fisher. Would very well be your lucky day. Spending hard-earned coin, that's an art in itself.
Let me have a look. So long.
I could have married a continental man.
Fresh meat!
But can you toss an axe? Me brother can.
Need help?
Like pickled herring? Me, I hate them.
Swords on his back. What'll they think of next?
You ain't from Ulfgaard, are yous?
Uncle said folk on the continent got heads like cats, but you only got cat's eyes. Jeepers, you're a wraith from Moorhall.
Ah! Oi, mate!
Lovely scar. Wanna see mine? Now here's a manly one. Not like my good for nothing Sven.
Hankering for some trotter day.
But can you toss an axe? Me brother can. Like a pickled herring. Me, I hate them.
Vagrant.
Not too many foreigners in the Isles in the olden days. Greetings, Watcher.
Farewell.
Odd, that one.
I'll take half from the horns. You take the other half from the hide.
What a relief for the gods.
The gods can hunt alone.
I say.
Maybe, but I've got good reason.
I hold Ciri dear too. You know this damn well. But the Mask of Orberos is no trifle. Have you any idea what could happen if it is used? Any idea of the consequences?
No, but neither do you. So stop panicking.
Can hear you two clear on the other side of the island.
Good. May all Skellige know, Jennifer of Vengerberg is a common thief!
Control yourself, Druid. I haven't stolen anything. I've merely borrowed something and fully intend to return it.
Ha! The generosity. Just one small problem. Once used, the mask is rendered completely worthless. Not to mention the risk you'll bury us alive, and all the Isles with us!
Barry, what are you talking about?
She's not told you? Might have expected as much. The myth is that Orberos created the mask when the envious seas swallowed his beloved. Unable to bear the prospect that he would never again see his betrothed, Orberos made the mask, which would allow him to peer into the past. He knew, however, that he could only use it once. So he waited. Waited until his longing grew so strong that it became unbearable. When the sea learnt of the mask, it was quick to respond. It made known its threat that whosoever used the mask would bring the sea's wrath down on them. For in vengeance, the sea would rise and flood all the lands and drown the living.
Where do you get this mask?
Sailors from Clan Dimmon pulled it from the sea, near the Njord Trench.
Yeah, but how can you be sure this is Urbaros's mask?
Its appearance is exactly as described in the myths.
You believe the myths?
Only ignorant fools belittle their significance. Besides, it's not the myths that are on trial here, it's the thief.
On the one hand, a theft. On the other, Ciri's life.
I also care deeply for the girl. I proposed a series of other methods. Yennefer refused to listen. She claimed they would take too long. Whereas she wants, she needs immediate results. She has always been hot-headed.
True. At least this time she's got a valid reason for it.
Never mind that she might bring... What? What was that? No. Yennefer's used the mask.
What was that?
Unicorns.
Damn it, Yen. I saw the foglets. I meant how'd they get here.
The power of the mask summoned them.
Ermion says the mask might cause a natural disaster.
Fortunate he's here, then. He can jump right in, try to tame it.
Realize he won't let this pass.
Oh, I'll survive, somehow.
What now?
The mask reveals the past. But only in certain places. Places where past events left a strong magical imprint. Take it.
Want me to wear it?
Yes. I'll cast a spell that will let me see through your eyes.
Gonna read my mind again?
You object?
You know I don't like it.
Let it go. I just want to see what happened. Besides, you know there are things I'd rather not know about you. Let's go. Already found the first spot. This is the spot. Put on the mask.
Any instructions?
Keep guard. You've seen everything. And don't stray far. Telepathy is limited in range.
What's that? A portal?
Two people emerged from it.
The woman was Ciri.
How can you know?
The way she moved. Like a witcher. Seems they went that way.
Come. Let's find the next spot.
What was that?
A magic explosion of some sort. So powerful that even the echo was dangerous. I wager it destroyed the forest.
But Ciri and her companion weren't harmed. I saw them escape.
Let's see where to.
Place is creepy. I don't like it.
Nor do I.
Anyone here when this happened had a slim chance of surviving.
I know what you're thinking, but don't worry. Ciri can take care of herself.
I learned this at
Don the mask.
Someone chased Ciri. See that? Might have wounded her.
She escaped through another portal.
Know where it led?
Magic residue trail leads to Velen.
Any chance you can figure out where Ciri's companion fled to? His portal's gotta be nearby.
I'll try to find it. Come. Well, ready? Use the mask.
Nice fight.
One repelled the other with powerful magic, then fled through a portal.
A mage?
Most likely. It's Ciri's companion and the one who wounded her.
How do you know?
I don't. Making an educated guess. They both appeared in the previous visions.
Ciri's got a powerful ally. The mage who was with Ciri fled too. Know where?
His trace path leads to Velen as well. But the target coordinates of his portal differ from those of Ciri's. The explosion must have disrupted his teleportation.
Ran into Kira Metz in Velen. Coincidence maybe, but she claimed a mage came to her looking for Ciri. Be surprised if it wasn't the same one.
Whoever he is, he grows more interesting by the minute.
Maybe something left of the one who got hit by the spell.
It's clearing up.
Ermion must be getting a handle on the weather.
Which means he'll be free to attack us again.
Are you pleased with yourselves? Look at what you've brought down on us! If someone's death were to help you find Ciri, would you start making human sacrifices as well?
Relax. Storm's died down. You've clearly got things under control.
For now. But who knows what will be a week or two on?
Stop panicking. Here's your mask.
It is worthless. It's an unwieldy ashtray at best. I hope you've learned something useful at least.
Very.
I'm talking to Geralt. You. You I'll deal with later. So?
We think a powerful curse was cast here.
Plausible. Considering what happened to the wood, do you know upon whom?
Not yet, but we know Ciri was here. She stepped out of a portal. A mage was with her. Someone chased them. They fought. Ciri was wounded, but managed to escape.
Where to?
Velen, probably. The mage opened a portal for her, then he fought her attacker.
Yes? Is that it?
Got a feeling we've found something interesting. Just need to examine one more thing.
It went flying in that direction.
Something's pinned under that tree. Can you...
I can.
Armor's clean. No blood, no sword nicks. Ciri's friend must have... what do you call it?
Vaporized him.
Exquisite. The armor. Oh, the workmanship's unfamiliar. Can't even tell where it's from.
Probably because it belonged to a rider of the Wild Hunt.
What? So it's true. The Wild Hunt. I feared as much. First here, then on Hindersfjall. What did they want?
They're looking for Ciri.
But why?
Elder blood flows in Ciri's veins.
It is true, she can trace her lineage clear back to Lara Doran, which is why the women in her family have always had extraordinary abilities. But could that truly be so important?
Ciri's exceptional. She travels between places here and other worlds. Space is no obstacle for her.
Huh?
Which is why the Wild Hunt wants to capture her. Speaking of the hunt, mentioned it appeared on Hindersfjall.
Well, it happened at least a fortnight after the cataclysm struck here on Ardskellig. The raids raided Lofoten at dusk in a blizzard. Itself a strange occurrence for that time of year. The islanders said the wraiths. They barged into their huts, killed anyone who resisted, then galloped inland, laughing fiendishly.
Anyone survive?
A dozen or so women, and an old man.
Next stop, Hindersfjall.
I'll meet you on the beach near Lofoten.
Mm-hmm. See you there.
Good luck to you. Inform me once you've learned anything new.
He's a weary biker.
Would you like to buy something for me, Stash?
Maybe. Let me see what you got. So long.
We were weary right here.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be. crushed legs. Bled to death after they wrecked.
Thank you. Show me what you got.
Greetings, Yen.
Good thing you're here. The frostbite was starting to set in.
Had a matter to tend to.
A matter that brooked no delay, I presume. What was it? A Necker contract?
Something like that. Can we go?
Quite a few years since I was last on Hindisfjall. But if I remember correctly, Lofoten should be this way. Raised huts and fresh graves. This must be it.
Gathering of some kind. We've come at a bad time.
There's no good time to talk about the Wild Hunt.
They barely sprouted whiskers, yet in the grind they lie. And me, livid and unharmed. Perhaps 'twere written in the stars.
What if Craven told the truth? What if he didn't abandon us, but was...
Stop! I won't speak at all.
He was our brother in blood. We sailed on the same longship, sat oar to oar, raided the Black Ones together.
But when they attacked, he fled. Abandoned his mom and sis. Abandoned us all.
Ritual of some kind. We'll have to wait.
We'll do no such thing. Dear sisters, pardon the interruption, but we've an important matter to discuss.
Can you not see we're commemorating the dead? So?
And we're looking for someone who's still alive. Please, this is urgent. Then speak.
They say the Wild Hunt destroyed this village.
That is true, though few believe us. You don't either, I'm sure. Did you see riders on skeleton horses, wearing frost-covered armor?
Aye, that's how it was. They landed on our shores in a ship made of the claws of dead men, like in the ballads. Leif yelled to grab the children. Then they came, cut him across his face. He tried to whisper, only blood came out.
You were to ask about someone, not prod their wounds. That's enough. What happened then?
Go on.
I ran out. To get help. To get Leif. But so many bodies. Yole. Ingvar. Little Neki.
Which way did the riders go?
Towards the sea, through the ravine, on horses made of bones. Bones and ice and...
Enough! Get to the point. Now.
We're looking for a young woman, name of Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes.
I'm sorry. She is not here.
Unless she lies in a grave. That is, I do not recall one by that name. But I've buried so many, I may have forgotten.
This Ciri, has she a scar here on her cheek?
Yes, yes, what happened to her?
Don't know. Saw her but for a moment, right before it all. She was in the stables, with Craven. 1,000 curses upon him.
This Craven you mentioned, does he have a name?
He did. Until the Elders struck him from the Saga of Ancestors.
It's as if he has ceased to exist. The lore forbids anyone from touching him, speaking to him, even uttering his name.
What did he do to deserve that?
He fled from the Wild Hunt. He alone.
We need to talk to him, even if it's not in keeping with your customs.
You've come too late. He went to the garden to fight Morkvag.
A coward who willingly seeks battle? Am I the only one who sees the contradiction?
That's why he did it. Craven knew he would prove the Elders wrong only if he killed Morkvarg.
And thus regain his honor and his name.
Trial by ordeal. Very Skellige.
I do not mock your lores. Please also respect ours.
Morkvarg. What's that?
Who, you mean?
The vilest man ever to inhabit Skellige. Nothing was ever sacred to him. He attacked his own clan's lands, took gold from Nilfgaard, killed children, pregnant women.
Know the type.
They said he feared only one thing, the wrath of the gods. Morkvarg sought to prove how wrong they were, so he sailed to Hindisfjall to ransack the goddess's garden. This was over a decade ago.
Archpriestess Ulva stood in his way. He thrust a blade between her ribs and cast her down in the mud. As her lifeblood left her, she cursed him. And Morkvarg transformed into a beast.
A curse? A monster? You've got some work to do.
I can get rid of Morkvarg. Don't know what he's turned into, but a silver sword should do the trick.
It's not that simple. There have been those who have bested Morkvarg.
yet he always returns.
So, it's a complex curse, meaning I need more information.
I understand, but I've told you all I know. Speak with Toradar's son, Einar.
He was in the garden when Mark Varg and his men attacked. He saw what happened. Of all the pilgrims there at the time, he alone escaped with his life. He settled in Larvik. You'll find him there at the landing, provided he's not out to sea when you arrive.
Where is this holy garden?
Not far from here. North. We cultivated healing herbs there once.
And now?
Now we walk only as far as the tree the goddess planted. We place our offerings and make our pleas before it.
Those who venture below remain in the garden forever.
Thanks for your help.
I understand you intend to enter the garden. I dislike it when foreigners enter the sacred grounds, but so be it.
Custom demands pilgrims make an offering of their own blood before the tree. Craven surely did so. Unless he lacked not only courage, but respect for Freyr as well.
You needn't worry about us. Geralt and I always give the gods the respect they are due.
What are you gonna do in this big house? They're not coming back. You're not too.
Worried this trail might have gone cold.
Even if Craven's dead, we'll manage.
How exactly?
You'll see when the time comes.
You could stand to be nicer sometimes.
I suppose. But then I wouldn't be the woman you fell in love with, would I?
Looks like rain.
My, my. That must be Morkarg. Quite the appetite.
Mm-hmm. Might even call it Wolven.
A bite. Just one morsel. One piece. A crumb. Food. Food. Shank! Not again! Not again!
He doesn't seem happy to see us.
Wait till he gets a closer look at me.
So, where should we start?
Let's go to that tree the sisters mentioned.
Plan to bleed yourself for the goddess?
Not necessarily, but Craven did. We just might pick up his scent. Craven was here. Look, the impression. Kneeled down on one knee. cut himself to make the offering. Bloodstains, see them?
No. I may be inhumanly beautiful, but I don't have superhuman senses. Not like you.
Which is why you should stay up here. No offense, but in that undergrowth and mud, you'd be like a...
ball and chain?
Planned to say it gentler, but yeah, that's basically what I had in mind.
Fine. We'll do as you say. If the need arises, I can cast spells from up here.
Thought you might object.
Me? Please. I can be extraordinarily conciliatory.
Yen, look me in the eye. What are you plotting?
Many things. How to seize the Temerian crown, how to sell Kaer Morhen out from under you. Go already.
Craven's blood, flowing profusely. Trail's clear. Should lead me to him. Something down there. Can't see a thing. Light prints. Craven trod carefully. No bite marks. Morkvarg doesn't eat his victims. Strange.
Is it Craven?
No, this one's been here a while.
What? I can't hear you. If you want to chat, come closer.
Her senses are really dulled. Monster tracks. Running. Chasing something. Like Morkvarg got bored of sneaking around and attacked.
Time to end.
Injured, started running. Odin's blood. Door won't budge. Craven must have blocked it, or it's just locked. Gotta go round. These prints should lead me to Craven, or his body. Morkvarg doesn't give up easily. Another corpse. No bite marks here either. Cross that. Gotta go down, provided I can open the sluice. Mechanism looks pretty standard. One lever to choose the sluice gate, the other to work it. man's blood. Prints lead to the well. Guess Craven didn't want to be eaten, preferred to drown. Symbol of Freya. Untouched. No sign of feeding. Morkvarg doesn't devour his victims. Strange.
It always grows back.
Starting to envy you.
Wish to hear a story?
If I have to, I'm all ears.
Warriors came. They knew they could not kill me. So they laid a trap. Chained me down. Locked me in here. Know what I did? I bit my leg off to free myself. Every bite brought pain and howling. I vomited blood.
Biting off your own limbs hurts. Who would have thunk?
You don't understand. This was more. My mouth burned like swallowing fire. As if all inside me was torn. Felt I would die. But I did it. And then I shredded them, dashed them to bits, made tiny crumbs of those plowing heroes.
Your story have a point. We're just doing some chest pounding.
The moral is, you cannot kill me. Cannot stop me. I'll not be bound. Break any fetters. Of course. Free me, or I'll return to get you again.
Talk now.
Only now can I. Such is the curse. Makes me bite, scratch, mangle, till I drop. You've got time before the blood's gone from me, and I return. Listen, carefully. Undo the curse. Free me. Finally, I will reward you.
Looking for a man named Craven. Apparently came here to kill you.
Seems it didn't work out. Those who come rarely introduce themselves. What did he look like?
No idea.
Then I cannot help you. I've shredded many.
Mentioned a reward of some kind.
Looted. Raided. Drunk most away. All but one. True treasure. Hid away. Yours. Just help me.
So, no joy in being a werewolf?
Nay, it's the worst, not the garden to which I'm bound, even, but the hunger. Anything I devour returns to ash. Ash, I cannot eat, I cannot drink, yet I bloody live and roam and prowl. The hunger is terrible. I bite my own flesh. But the smallest morsel burns my throat like boiling tar.
Everlasting hunger, classic as curses go. Goes to explain why all those corpses went untouched.
Help! Or I'll return to shred you, rip you limb from limb.
See what I can do.
See and do, or I shall return.
Tiresome conversation. Not interested.
What will you do?
What a witcher ought to.
Let me know once you find Craven.
Craven's blood. has been for a while.
Yen, found him.
And?
And I've seen rot fiends in better condition than this.
Shit. Fine, scrape together what you can and haul the bits up here.
Take it you've got a plan?
No, I just like to stare at rotting flesh. We'll talk when you get here, all right?
That's Yen, charming as ever. Come on, someone wants to meet you.
Oof. Putrefaction set in. But the vocal cords are intact. We might still get something out of him.
Doesn't look like the talkative type.
Anyone can be made to talk. Even a corpse. One must simply know how.
Thought necromancy was strictly forbidden.
So is premarital sex. But I'm not about to be bothered by such foolishness.
Black magic's no joke. Casting those spells never ends well. Never.
I don't like it any more than you do, believe me. But the thought that Ciri is in danger? I like that even less.
I understand. Still doesn't give us the right to...
Geralt, please. This is not the time to debate ethics.
Need any ingredients for the spell?
The blood of a newborn, a virgin's tongue, and the eye of a newt.
Mind trying again without the sarcasm?
I don't need a thing. I'm a sorceress, not a village herbalist. All I need is energy. A great deal of energy. We're very lucky this place is saturated with magic.
It's also considered sacred. Priestesses will be furious if you use the garden's power to revive a corpse.
Geralt, you're getting on my nerves. I offer you solutions, you try to poke holes in them.
I'm not poking holes, just thinking about the consequences. How about you? Giving them any thought?
No. Geralt, I'll say it again. We're short on time. Ciri is short on time. Fine. You busy yourself pouting. I'll handle the rest.
Selaine, Selaine, Dufresne! Selaine, Selaine, Davidar! Craven of Lofoten.
No, I have a name. I am a skull.
We're looking for Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes. Have you seen her?
She's blue eyes. Curse me.
I don't care about that. What happened to her? What was she doing here? Speak!
No!
Speak! Speak!
She fell! Oh, almost drowned!
Ciri. Zirel. Can you hear me?
I can.
I must leave you now. We will meet beneath drowned dead rock. Can you remember? Repeat it.
Drowned dead rock.
You're awake. And I thought you'd...
Where am I? And who are you?
It's all right. You're on Hindersfjall, village of Lofoten. They call me Skjall.
But how'd I... What?
We fished you out of the sea. Me and that friend of yours.
And where is he? My friend?
Stepped out a while ago. Said he needed to find a boat. Why does he wear that mask? Something not right with his mug?
No. He simply doesn't like others to see it. How long did I lie there?
All day, nearabouts. 'Twas morn when we brought you in. Night's near come now.
Damn. Too long.
You needed the rest. Desperately. Been through a lot, eh? Got some nasty, fresh-looking scars.
Yes. I've been through a lot.
I never thought women on the continent did any fighting.
Sometimes they have no choice. Help me stand.
I don't think you should...
Less talk, more giving me a hand.
Ah, that's me brother for you. Out of sight for a second, and he's already put his paws on a girl.
Astrid, you're as dim as dishwater. You know perfectly well I'm helping her up.
It's a shame, I know, but I've got to interrupt your courtship. Come, we're off to the sauna.
Where?
Why's your mouth agape like you're noodling for an eel? The sauna. Girl, you was blue as a whale when we brought you in here. Your blood needs thawing.
Really, there's no need. I feel fine now.
Hey! Fine? You can't stand on your own 2 feet. And it's no surprise with your muscles frozen stiff. But don't you worry. Mom and I will take care of you.
I'm sorry. But I must get to Drowned Dead Rock. As fast as possible.
I shan't force you to stay. But the rock's a ways off and you can barely walk. You'd best take a horse.
True. Skjall can prepare a horse for you. You'll have to wait a spell, but even so, you'll get there faster than on foot.
Fine, that'll do. Thank you both very much.
Pish posh, there's no need. Now come, we gotta sweat the sick out of you.
Where are my clothes?
I've taken them already. Come on. That man in the mask, he's from afar, isn't he?
Oh yes. From very far away.
Where exactly?
Aren't you nosy?
Surprised? Been sitting in this fish puddle me whole life. I'd love to travel like you.
Like me? No, you wouldn't like that. Trust me.
In you go and get out of those rags.
All of them?
I should think so.
yourself in a towel. Well, whatever makes you comfortable.
Finally. I was so worried you'd...
Ach, Mum, you always worry. Everything's fine, ain't it?
Yes, it's fine.
Good. That's good. But why have you got the towel, child? It'll just get wet.
Mum, she's from the continent. She's shy.
I'm not at all shy. I just wanted something to sit on.
Expect me to believe that?
Astrid, behave yourself, or I'll send you to gut fish with your pa. Here we are, gabbing away. Steam's gone. Gotta douse the coals.
Say, back home, have you got saunas too?
I'd rather not talk about myself.
Why's that?
Someone might come looking for me. I wouldn't want to cause you any trouble.
It's too late for Skjall.
What?
He's head over heels for you, girl. Sat at your bedside all the day, staring like he was painted by a master.
Astrid, I asked you not to tell her.
Oops. Well, now the milk's spilt. Do you fancy Skjall?
Well, he seems nice.
Oh my. He's that bad?
Leave it, Astrid. Who she likes is her affair, and it's not to you.
Listen, it's lovely sitting here with you, but I really must go now.
I understand. Who'd want to stay in this hole? We're all related three times over, and the air stinks of fish.
I can't see how you're related to anyone here. No one in Lofoten groans and bitches quite like you do. Sit down and be quiet. Child. Skjall's certain to have readied the horses by now. But before you go, you ought to take a quick jump in the water. It'll do you good.
I'm sorry, but I really must go. Thank you once more.
And once more, there's no need. Gods bless your journey.
Cold.
storms are coming. Gotta go to your mom. Tell her to take the wash down. You keep practicing.
Aye.
If your fingers tire, grip the string with.
No need. It won't tire.
Oh, you're here. The horses are ready.
As am I. Shall we ride?
Listen, I hope... My sister, she didn't talk any nonsense to you, did she?
No. Except to mention that you fancy me.
What? But I asked her... Besides, it's not... Of course, you are very... But... You know what? Let's ride. You're in a hurry and it'll be dark soon.
I'm not in that much of a hurry. Your first kiss, wasn't it?
Of course it weren't. Aye, me first.
We don't have much time, but it's enough for you to learn a few things.
Run for your lives!
You stay here! I'll go and...
I can look after myself.
Yeah.
What was that?
The Wild Hunt.
Ragnarok? The world's end?
Well, not yet. But I must go. They're here for me.
Get on the horse. I'll show you the way to the rock.
You should stay. See to Astrid, your mum.
Afterwards. Once I'm sure you'll make it. Let's go.
Watch out! Ride, silly! Don't look back! Faster! Faster, they're catching up!
What?
The what?
Right?
No.
Get on up.
You should...
After.
Watch out! Ride, silly! Don't look back! Faster! Faster! They're catching up!
What became of that creature? Where is he?
Stop! Hurt!
What?
Saw him and stood on, but he sold him.
To whom?
Don't know.
Be gone.
Did you tell them?
Be gone, I say.
Yen, are you all right?
I'm fine now. The spell. Imagine putting wriggling cockroaches in your mouth, or swimming in manure. That's more or less how it felt.
What? What happened to the garden?
It died. Like I said, the spell, it requires a great deal of energy.
You knew it would end like this, didn't you? Didn't consider it worth mentioning?
No. I knew you'd protest. Your sense of decency is charming, but it does get in the way sometimes.
Could have shown some sympathy for the boy.
That was no boy, Geralt. It was a hunk of rotting, rancid flesh that spoke through my magic.
Didn't just speak. It howled in pain.
I know it seemed real, but it was no longer human. Do you understand? Geralt, I know we should talk, but not here, all right? I don't wish to stay a moment longer.
The garden! Our garden! How could you? We helped! And you! Inconceivable!
Now.
Don't you dare try to calm me! We've every right to be furious! Furious! And you! You will pay for this!
We had no choice. We'd never have learned what happened to her.
Do you really think you're justified? That your hunt for a foreign woman gives you the right to destroy our garden?
I'm sure it doesn't in your eyes.
I shall make sure all Skellige hears what you did here.
Wait. I did this. I alone. Geralt tried to stop me. I refused to listen.
I might have known. They warned me about you. Sorceresses. None shall open their door to you. None shall feed your hunger, and none shall tend to your wounds.
Yen, you didn't have to do that.
But I wanted to. I'd rather not talk about it. We must focus on what Skell told us.
Key to finding Ciri is that ugly thing Skell saw on the beach. That's what I think. You know, I saw something or someone who looked just like that.
Where?
In Velen, at a castle until recently ruled by a self-proclaimed baron, now controlled by his right-hand man, Sergeant Ardal.
You must go and get the creature. I don't know, buy him, kidnap him.
The thing's clearly cursed. Its mind is a jumble. Can't have anything resembling a normal conversation with it.
Grumbling won't get us anywhere. All will be well. A curse, please. Nothing a sorceress and a witcher couldn't handle. Now, tell me. Do you... No. Never mind.
You were gonna ask me something. What was it?
Tell me, do you think, is there a chance that thing might be Ciri? That, well, she's been transformed by some curse?
Don't even want to think about it.
Geralt, we must.
Might be. From what I know, she was looking to cure a powerful curse while in Novigrad. But I'll lose it if I try to deal with that possibility now. We have to do what we can, see what happens. Didn't learn much, though we can be sure Ciri's not in Skellige anymore. Not in Velen or Novigrad either. She's disappeared. Again.
Perhaps we should re-examine what we've learned. We might have missed a clue that would push us forward.
Certainly hope that's the case. Makes me wonder what she's gotten herself into.
Can't even begin to imagine. But we will pull her out of it. Safe and sound. That I promise you.
Ciri's trail in Skellige. We followed it, exhausted the possibilities. Might be time to go back to the continent.
Before you do, there's one thing. It's important.
What's that?
Let's meet in Larvik, at the Warriors' Hall. We'll speak there.
Can we do this later? Sorry, need to take care of something.
Well, if you must, you must. I shall wait for you in Larvik for a time. If you don't make it, we'll meet in Vizima. After all, we do owe the Emperor a report.
Ciri's our concern, ours alone.
Perhaps. But that is not what we agreed with Amir. We must see him.
Being awfully loyal to your patron.
He's your patron as well, dear. Don't forget that, lest he remind you of it himself.
If we gotta, we gotta. So be it.
We'd never have known Ciri had returned if not for Emma and his agents. We owe him this.
See you, Yen. Take care of yourself.
Wait. This matter in Larvik. It really is important to me. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tarry.
Freya's priestesses. No signs of violence. Must have died of hunger a while ago. Must have hid here when Morkvarg raided the garden. A key could come in handy. slower. Come on, Roach. Slow now. Whoa. Something really did tear him to pieces.